search with pictures on Bing, and also learn how to build skills based upon that search with my good friend Robbie on this episode of The AI Show. Welcome to another episode of The AI Show. We're going to talk about visual search with my friend Robbie. How are you doing, my friend?
Good. Great to be here.
All right. Why don't you tell us what it is that we're talking about today?
Sure. What we're working on in Bing is something we call visual search. Basically, visual search is basically uploading an image and searching on that image, basically based on the content, what's in the image.
So wait, hold on, because that's sounding a little sci-fi to me. You're saying instead of typing in like Gears of War because you want to play the game, you upload a picture of it.
Exactly, because there's a lot of things that you want to know about the world that you can't really express in words. For example, there's this picture of this flower. You know, if I saw that on the street, how do I really try to find out what that flower is, right?
Sure.
There's no way to really describe that in words that'll try to get the right result. So what we're doing is being able to just take a photo of it, and we'll find what that is by identifying the flower.
What kind of magic sauce are you using for that? Can you tell us?
Yeah, we're doing a lot of stuff. So the first thing we're doing is we're doing things like detecting of objects mm-hmm. and entities in the image. We're also using various DNN models to recognize various entities in the image. And then we're also searching for similar images across the web to find similar images that provide us knowledge back about the original image.
That's amazing. Can you show us how it works?
So what we're actually releasing, at Build, we released the Visual Search API, which allows developers to get access to all of the content that we just kind of went through. So developers can go here and get a various set of recognition capabilities. Mm-hmm. For example, detecting animals, detecting flowers, detecting landmarks. And the other cool thing is some of the things that we detect, like fashion items, like clothing and shoes, we're actually able to find similar products that you can buy online. So let's say I really liked your shirt. I could just take a picture of it and find places to buy that shirt or a shirt that looks just like it.
And this is an API that I can use inside of my applications.
Exactly.
That's cool.
It's part of the Cognitive Services API, which will allow you to infuse intelligence and AI into your products and services.
So it looks like you have a lot of awesome capabilities. What else can it do?
So good question, actually. What we actually announced is the Bing Visual Search Developer Platform. So what it allows is developers to extend the capabilities of visual search to create their own new scenarios by providing new knowledge or providing new actions. So for example, in this screen, you see you take a picture of a furniture table. A furniture outlet skill can provide you where you can find similar products like that to buy.
I see. So is this something that as a developer I would build, and when someone searches for an image, then my skill would come up and say, yo, you're looking at furniture. We sell furniture.
Exactly. Actually, the best way to do this is actually kind of demo and show you some skills.
Awesome.
So here's a set of like visual skills that we kind of have here. So for example, in the first one, it's an interesting fruit. If you look at that, you probably won't know what that is. So you just take a picture, and we have a skill, that, for example, that provides you what recipes you can make with that particular fruit. Similarly, you take a picture of a landmark, we can provide you various information about it as a skill. Another one is if you take a picture of a flower, you know, how do you take care of a particular flower, right? And it provides that as a skill as well.
I see. So how does a developer set this up?
Great question. So I'll actually go to building a skill for you.
Okay.
So you can go to basically bingvisualsearch.io and start building a skill.
Cool.
So I'll create a skill that's very simple where, given a picture of food, it'll find where I can get that nearby.
Okay.
And I'll leverage Bing for this. So I'm just going to create a new skill. So I'm going to call it Food Near Me. And of course, I'm making it. Finds food nearby.
So as you're typing this in, is this creating something that when someone goes to Bing and does a search, your skill will show up? Or I'm trying to find where this fits.
Sure. So wherever the Bing Visual Search API is leveraged across Microsoft first-party services, it'll be exposed there. Currently, we're exposing this in the Bing iOS app, and in the future, Bing and other Microsoft first-party services.
I see. So if you build a skill, like let's just say you're a restaurateur that has many restaurants, and you want to be able to inject a skill based upon what people look at, or they search for a picture of like a pie, then it'll show up and be like, oh, you can go see where we can buy pies.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So I just submitted all the info about my skill. The next part is actually building your skill. And we actually have three simple steps, and that's all that's required. So the first step is, when should we trigger your skill? So we call this visual intent. Visual intent is defined as, what is the most likely intent of the image given the content of the image? So for example, if the picture is of a glass, it's probably about finding about that drink or where you can find similar glasses. Or if it's a picture of a shirt, it's probably trying to buy it or find similar products. So we have two options here. One option is that you can always trigger your skill, or you can actually customize with visual intents. So we provide you a set of visual intents, and we're growing these constantly and improving upon them. So in this case, for the food one, I'm going to actually look for food and drink. So in this case, when there's a picture of a food item, it'll call my skill. When there's no picture of food, it won't call my skill. So it'll save my capacity and bandwidth for my skill. Then the next part we ask is that, what data should we send to you? So at Bing, as part of our API, we recognize a lot of things. So we can send things like annotations that are terms that describe what's in the image. We can send the raw image. We can detect various objects and send that as part of the metadata we send to you, or even OCR.
Sure.
So you can kind of pick and choose what you want. So for in this case, I want Bing to actually tell me what the food item is, because I don't know myself as a... So in this case, I want Bing to kind of tell me what the food item is.
Okay.
So I'm going to choose annotations. The next and third thing we ask for is the service URL. So where your code is actually hosted. So I already have my code and a link, but I'll just kind of brief through the code here. So the code here is basically very simple. It looks pretty large just because there's so many comments.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at it, the actual code to run a skill is actually very simple. So this is like the raw set of information we need to run your skill. And of course, no one should code this way because you want proper error handling.
Sure.
And all those kinds of things. So in this skill, what we're doing is that HTTP request is being sent to my code, and I'm parsing through the annotations metadata that's being sent to me.
Which is what you requested, right?
Exactly.
Yep.
And then based on the annotations, I'm creating a response back, and then I'm crafting what the preview text should be, the image URL, and the click-through experience be. And then I'm just packaging that back into a response in the body.
It's like a little card-looking type thing.
Exactly.
Cool.
Exactly. So I have a link for this service. And basically, that's it. You just built a skill. And now we can actually start testing it. So I have an image of my dinner last night.
Nice. You're making me hungry, man.
So I'm going to actually take this picture and upload it. And then the minute you upload it, we start running our API and start getting all the information about this image.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the JSON response that's actually being sent to your service based on the configurations you made earlier.
Cool.
So you can use this to code against it, check and debug and all sorts of things. And then the next thing you can do is actually click run. And this is where it actually hits your code and waits for the response and generates a little preview. So here you can see it created a little preview. It recognized that the food in the image is fried rice, and it said, search Bing for fried rice near me. And then I can just click on this, and it'll go to Bing.
That's nice. And you can put whatever you want in that card. You might be able
exactly.
to deep link into like a specific category of products in your own website as part of the search results.
Exactly.
So this is, now I'm understanding. This is enabling, like in a generic like search engine, to actually provide specific customization based upon what people are seeing, not necessarily what they're typing. Is that what you're doing?
Yes, exactly.
That's amazing. Cool.
And I have one special skill just for you.
Oh, let's see it.
We call it the hot dog or not skill.
This is important. This is like we could build an entire company on this.
We made sure this works end to end before we shipped anything.
That's right.
So here I could take a picture of, let's say, for example, this pizza, and I'm going to upload this. And I'll run, and then you can see, detected, it's not a hot dog.
There you go. I mean, this is cool. All right, now we got to put the hot dog in to make sure it actually really works. Because you can't.
Exactly. There
nice.
You go.
Nice. Awesome. So where can people go to get started on learning how to do this?
So they just go to bingvisualsearch.com, mm-hmm. and all the information, documentation, and everything is over there. And then we also have one other feature that we're releasing.
Let's see it.
Very soon, which is allowing you to test your skill on the Bing iOS app.
Oh.
So it's very simple for you to just go around, start taking pictures of things and see if your skill triggers and get new ideas on how to build skills.
That's amazing. Like, I got to build a skill. Like, is that Seth or not? You know, so people as they're wandering around the world will know, is that really Seth? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Would you use that skill?
Of course.
Yeah, because he, of course. Well, thanks so much for spending some time with us, Robbie. This has been amazing. We've been learning all about visual search and how to build skills on top of Bing Visual Search. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.